Do anything you can, but do not tell a narcissist how happy you are. Do not share it with them. Do not express your joy, for they will destroy every good thing out of their jealousy for you. They are really envious. They do not want you to grow. They do not want you to blossom. They want you to wither away, fade away, because that makes them feel powerful. So anytime you come across as cheerful, it burns them. They feel equally sad, and that's why they create chaos. Let's talk about this further in today's episode. Hi, I am Danish, a psychologist and a narcissistic abuse recovery professional. In this episode, we are going to thoroughly understand why you can never share your happiness with a narcissist, why you can never show them you're truly happy. If that sounds interesting and you're eager to learn more, please make sure to subscribe, because your subscription to the channel helps in spreading awareness about narcissistic abuse. Narcissists are notoriously known for destroying all the big days in your life. It's Christmas Eve, and all of a sudden they start fighting with you over a petty thing, something that you didn't do properly while cooking dinner. It's your birthday, they pretend to be sick, and everybody has to cater to their needs. It becomes their special day when it was supposed to be about you. It's your graduation ceremony, they do not show up, or they show up late intentionally. And if they show up, they sulk. You do not see any happiness on their face. Then it's your marriage ceremony or marriage day, marriage anniversary. They intentionally drop something on your dress, or they take a lot of time to get ready, and then it turns into a very bitter experience. I know you know all that. I know you know what they do. The biggest question is, why do they do it? Experts on narcissism will tell you, oh, they are extremely insecure. They have to have everybody's eyes on them. If it is not about them, they are going to destroy it. That is true. But the simplest explanation that I personally have for you is, they are jealous. They are sadistic in that they can't see you happy. That's it. And there is no explanation beyond that. They want you to cry. They want you to be sad. And then you might ask, why is that? I can't understand it. You're not able to understand it because you're not like them. You can never ever do that to anybody on their special day, will you? And that's why you are shocked. But that's what a narcissist is all about. They are fun suckers, joy killers, and merchants of chaos. In fact, they embody a lot of chaos. Inside, they're undergoing through a lot of turbulence, but suppress it. When their environment does not sink in with what their internal experience is, it makes them aware of their own rottenness. When they see you happy, they feel their own unhappiness. When they see you accomplishing a lot in their life, they personalize it and make it about their failures. And they do not just become sad about it. They do not even acknowledge that it's going on. They interpret those sensations they feel, driven by shame, as attacks by you when you did nothing. They become really angry at making them feel a certain way, which is why they launch attacks at you. Which truly proves that everything, positive or negative, is all about a narcissist. It has to be about them. If it is not, then it's not important. And if they can't make it unimportant, they will destroy it. To stabilize their internal environment, what do? They fill their external environment with a lot of negativity. At what expense though? Your stability, peace, calmness, happiness, joy, and success. They belittle your achievements on purpose so that you do not feel happy about them. They are jealous. They can't have it, so they will destroy it. This is how a narcissist's brain works. If they can, they will. That gray area, if I should, is missing. They don't ask that question, if I should. No, if I can, I will. If they can belittle you and face no consequences, they will belittle you. If they can humiliate you, if they can control you, they will. So that area where our conscience acts, where we access our moral compass and then analyze the situation if it is appropriate or not, if our actions are appropriate or not, is totally missing in them. That's why they are so reckless. It is their jealousy for you that drives them to run massive smear campaigns and fabricate narratives. It is their enemy that burns them day in and day out, keeps them thinking about you and your success 24/7, plotting and planning, trying to strategically destroy it. They can't stand you expanding. They can't stand you flying high. They have to chain you. And again, you may wonder why? Well, just you can't understand it beyond the fact that it makes them feel powerful. That's it. How it is internalized, we can't say that because you are not a narcissist. I am not a narcissist. We can only say that it's just pathetic. It's evil. That is the definition of evil. For these reasons, if you are still dealing with a narcissist or if you are living with one, pretend to be suffering and struggling. If that is what the narcissist wants from you, we call it conscious fawning. It's a tactic that you can use in situations where the narcissist is constantly trying to destroy your life and they want to see you suffer. By doing so, you will avoid unnecessary attention and you can give them false satisfaction that, yeah, I'm struggling, now leave me alone if that is what you wanted. However, be very cautious with this technique, for it cannot be applied or used in all situations. You have to analyze the narcissist you're dealing with, what they want from you, and then decide if this is applicable to you or not. If you are dealing with such a monster in a narcissistic co-parenting situation, then stay low-key. Separate your world from theirs. Do not share your achievements with them. Yes, record them for documentation purposes, but do not share with them only for showing them how amazing you are. You indeed are amazing. You are a dual parent. You are the father as well as the mother. However, you cannot share anything with them, but they will destroy it. They will find a way to ruin it for you. Keep it to yourself. Stay low key. Play your game. Know what pushes their buttons and if need be, push those buttons only to protect yourself. Use their narcissistic traits against them. And one way to do that in this context would be just do better. When they will see you doing better, they may want to keep up with you and that will pressure them to play along. Let them see, but do not show. That is what I would say you should follow. This episode also answers one of the most commonly asked questions. Can you ever be happy with a narcissist? Of course not. Why? Because they won't let you be happy. And if you ever try to be happy, they will destroy it. They will steal it away. They cannot stand watching you flourish. That's it. Keep that in mind. Embody it. And then understand that there is no way also to be happy while living separately in the same house. You cannot. As I said, they're merchants of chaos. They may not say or do anything. Their presence is heavy and evil enough to suck joy, all joy out of your life. It just, the moment you talk to them is when you start feeling depressed naturally. Their energy is that low. What have been your experiences with what I just described? Drop your answers in the comments below. And with that, let's bring this episode to an end. Thank you so much for tuning in and listening. I will talk to you in the next one. Until then, as always, let the healing begin and continue.